Good afternoon. Can I firstly welcome you here and then request that mobile phones are switched off, please? I'm giving notice that the hearing is recorded. It's been filmed for subsequent broadcasts on the council's website. Therefore, by entering the chamber, you are consenting to being filmed and to the possible use of those images and sound recordings for broadcasting and/or training purposes, as your images cannot be removed post-recording. If you are a member of the public and do not wish to have your image captured, you should sit in the appropriate seats in the public gallery at the rear of the chamber. If you have any queries regarding this, please speak to one of the council's staff. There are no fire drills scheduled, so if the alarm is heard, the exits are clearly marked if the fire alarm sounds. I'm Councillor Janice Howard, and I will ask my colleagues on the bench to introduce themselves.
I'm Councillor Pauline Cooper.
And I'm Councillor Nick Draper.
I'm Guy Bishop, the legal advisor to the company.
Amy Dimitrescu, Democratic Services.
The subcommittee will follow the hearing procedures, a copy of which was included in the notice pack sent to you. I'm now going to ask the legal advisor to inform those present that the subcommittee had a briefing prior to the hearing.
Yes, just a legal norm, just explaining to you that the committee sits before the meeting to read the papers and make sure that they've read all the documents and your application fully so they can make a proper decision. In meeting with them, I referred them to Councillor Kirby's representation as well as various bits and pieces of your application.
For the licensing team, are there any technical issues you feel should be brought to our attention?
My name's Elizabeth MacDonald. I don't think there's anything that isn't already in the application pack.
I would now like the applicant to take the floor and present, and maybe introduce yourself as well.
Press the silver button.
Got it?
Sorry?
It's okay.
My name is Roshan Asha, and I'll be representing my dad today, Ashish Asha, on this case today. So, it's just here, I was here because of the language problem. So, I'm just presenting that, and I'm just going to go ahead and. So I think what was brought forward was the antisocial behaviour. That's what someone commented for application. I just want to point out that obviously eating is not an antisocial behaviour. We've been open for many years in that area. And we don't serve alcohol at all. We serve hot food. We don't serve to, if we know someone is drunk or behaving antisocial, we want some and we want to allow them inside the shop. First of all, we don't want to get anyone in that sort of state in that area. Especially because there's no one there that causes any problems. If we do see anything like that, my dad knows, the people who work around there knows that they're not to serve them, they're not even allowed them inside. And we don't allow people to come into the shop in groups. We have the right to stop them if they're in groups. Maybe 4 or 5 years ago there were people hanging around in groups, but the last 3 years, 3 to 4 years, there's literally all that has stopped. School children will be allowed into at the time, so that's another thing that we've done. There is 9 CCTV cameras, there's 2 outside and the remaining 7 are inside that record. And we are always ready to provide these details, the information to the local authority or the police if we have to. Once we did to catch a number plate, because the CCTVs are placed in a way that catches the front of the shop as well as the street. So we did provide CCTV, I think about a year and a half ago, to the police. So we did, we are always willing to help local authority. We have got a massive sign, so we can't see around here a bit. So we've got a sign around the shop. This is just for our own. It just says that notice, please leave the premises quietly to avoid disturbing the local residents. Thank you. So that's literally on the side of the wall. It's just a little message for our customers. They don't make any noise when they leave, but it's just there. Just respect the neighbours. There is no smoking allowed in the area as well. Just to mention about other things. So we have the main link that connects Gatwick Airport to Central London, that connects through London Road. So we've got many cab drivers, local taxis that goes off, and this has been their spot for food at 12 o'clock or 11 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock. So we've been serving these people as well as their customers for many years. And there is also a 24-hour tube station a couple of miles down the road, Tooting, Kirby station. There is around 32 buses that go past our shop hourly, 16 in each way, until 12:46 a.m. in the morning. So these are people that are coming back from doing the London nightlife or coming back from work. I think majority, 80% I would say, are coming back from work. Because we do have a chat with them after, and they tell us about the day and the work life. We've got a Tooting railway station, which is literally less than a minute walk from our shop, I think about 30 seconds. I think that operates until, 11:45 is the last train there. So that's another thing that's there. And then we've got a 264 bus, that's a 24-hour bus that connects St George's Hospital all the way through Mitcham, Carshalton, all the way up to Croydon. So we've got a lot of patients and nurses coming through that bus who stop by, because we've got bus stop is literally outside our shop, who get food for themselves at night time. And the bus 4477, that's the last stop. So that comes straight from Victoria, Lake Victoria, and Stockport, I think it is. So that stops literally outside our shop. And those people, so mainly we cater for food for people who work during the night. So we've also been serving for loads of paramedics who stop by, police officers who stop by. We've got a lot of people coming from the Morden Theatre as well, and that's another thing that we get. I think the previous, we're allowed until 5 o'clock. We don't really want it until 5 o'clock. I mean, we don't want to serve food. I think the maximum we're going to do is 2 o'clock, which we thought was reasonable. And we didn't just come up with this number just randomly, but we thought we spoke to the customers that we get. We asked them, for the past year, we've been speaking to them as well, finding out what time they finish work, what time they usually pass the shop. So they said 2:30, so we thought 2 sounds reasonable. It does say on the notice, it says, it's antisocial behaviour, but there's loads of pubs there that sell alcohol that's allowed to open until 2 o'clock, and we sell food. So I found it really hard to understand, places that serve, alcohol and loud music are allowed to open until 2 o'clock, but places that sells food to the local resident need to be shut at 11, which I didn't really understand.
Sorry, what places are open until 2?
The Grange Park pub, which is located 3 shops next to us, on the right, and the Brick and Liquor, which is also on Mitcham Road, which is on Mitcham Road actually, that's open to 12 and 2 on the weekends. That's that. And there's a kebab shop, which is literally opposite that, the whole house is which is on it. They are open to 4 o'clock in the morning, literally opposite us. And there's another shop, which is chicken shop, opposite ours. They decide to open to whenever they want. They sometimes close at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4. So, I mean, we've got food rating at 5-star, which my dad has worked very hard over the past 4 years to get to that stage, and then, you know, getting told to close at 11 o'clock. I mean, that's our busiest period. Well, not the busiest, but we've been serving for some of our main customers. And, yeah, so I just don't think that anything stated reflects to what we do. So I'll just pass. You want to pass this picture to someone now, or can you come in? We also have a screen that's fitted inside the shop at the front, just to let people know that they are being filmed. And so it's not just a camera, like, you know, it can be a dummy or anything, but this screen actually shows them that they're being live recorded. So it's just a thing for them to think about as well, so they know. And we've got a main street camera, that's, I think, is this automatic camera that gets operated by local through a local property police. That spins like crazy sometimes, you know, just recording the whole area. So there's
customers,
yeah, so we've been, all of our customers are mainly, I'd say, working people, work at night and they come back. So yeah, that's it.
Thank you. I'm now going to ask for any questions from my colleagues alongside me.
Hi. Just get me straight. You haven't opened before after 11 o'clock before now. It's the stretch of applications.
Yes,
that's right. Okay. I just wondered how you were aware of the trade that was around after 11 o'clock at night.
So when you said that, though, we did open to 11, 12:30, 12 o'clock sometimes, and even 12:30 sometimes, but this was just an off weekend thing, not knowing there was a license thing that we had to follow. So as soon as we were told from that day, we stopped. I was actually on holiday, my dad gives me a call and says, you know that we have to close at 11 o'clock, and I said, what, really? So since that day, I think it was in December. Yeah, it was in December sometime. So since then, we closed 10 to 11, so it leaves enough time for the staff to leave.
Don't worry, I'm not judging you, don't worry. The question that I came in here going to ask, I found very interesting talking about the kind of literally passing trade. Do you think there are people on the streets at 11 o'clock who would want to be coming in specifically? You could probably answer that in the context. Do you do a delivery service as well?
We started, yeah.
Fine, okay. Are you anticipating a large proportion of delivery, or do you reckon you get a lot of over-the-counter sales as well?
This is the thing, I think because of the... Oh yeah, the delivery shuts at 11 o'clock.
Delivery finishing
place? Yes, and they don't serve to orders of places like Deliveroo, and I believe Uber Eats, we haven't started Uber Eats yet, but Deliveroo is the one that we've been doing at the moment, and they shut to an area at 11 o'clock. So yeah, no one allowed to place an order, I think quarter to going.
So this is purely counter sales?
It is, yeah.
And
sorry, you're at 11 o'clock at night at that time, are you aware of there being a lot of customers on the street who want to be eating with you?
Definitely, yeah, because that area is busy. I mean, people probably finish work, so as I said, there's a high bus route that goes and there's a long stops. It's literally between Croydon and Tooting, one of the busiest areas. So at 11 o'clock, there is a lot of people, especially in this weather. So it's about summer, it just goes crazy. Like, there are people around enjoying the park, which is right next to us. There's a beautiful park called this Marsh Park, right next to us, within a couple of this walk. So that the railway is another thing that I would say. That's where we get most of our customers from. Both railway and the 24-hour tube station, Tooting Broadway.
I have a question. You've applied for a licence till 2 a.m. for 7 days a week. Can you explain your thoughts around Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday night, which are traditionally much quieter and many premises don't even open on Monday night?
It's a valid point that you have, but the area is very big. I mean, the shops opposite us, especially in the last, since December, we've been closing up 10 to 11. And the amount of customers they get at these times, is you'd be surprised to see the amount. Because I think it's because you get free parking in that area. So that brings a lot of people by car or bus again, and then the train routes. So with those two shops and another couple just down the road, there's plenty of shops, and you'd be surprised to see how many people there will be in those shops at 2 o'clock in the morning. And sometimes I've seen people just rapidly reaching close the door at 2 o'clock because they've run out of food for that day.
Of course.
Yeah.
Yes, I have. Excuse me. I have a question. If I'm right, you seem to imply that a lot of restaurants close to you, open till fairly early in the morning, much more so than you're asking to. Is that a fact, or is that just what you think?
It's actually on the yellow pages, so you can check these. Or if you just type in the pictures I've given you, I think these pictures have the name of the shops, the two shops that's literally opposite us. If you type that in Google, the first thing comes up is the time they open up to. So they are the kebab shop, 100%. I know that they are open till 4 o'clock every single day without stopping for the past 4 or 5 minutes. Yeah, because we've been living in Mitchell since 2001, so we've known that shop for a very, very long time. But the chicken shop, I believe they have a time till 4 o'clock, that's just me. This is what I think, but they're open till 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. Sometimes they even shut at 1 o'clock. I think it depends on who's available as a staff and if it's busy or not.
The licensing team for any comments or clarifications you'd like to make?
I don't really know what you'd like to clarify. I think that there used to be a license that went to a 5 at that address that is no longer being used. So that is the truth. I can't say about the premises opposite. I'd have to check our files. And that's if they're in Merton, because I know that there's a funny border there where the road, one side of the road is Wandsworth, isn't it? And the other side is Merton.
Right.
And I don't know if the other side of where you are is Merton or Wandsworth. But without checking our records, I can't tell you whether what he's saying is right.
I can tell you that the south side of the railway bridge, both sides of the road are in Merton. The north side of the railway bridge, the right side, the eastern side is in Merton, the western side.
And your down from? From the railway bridge?
We are, the side of the road.
So both sides are, but I'd have to check our records to see what those were. Or if you don't want to give me the details, I'd like to know what I'm going
to. I take it the Gorringe hours are correct, at 2 a.m. I think.
I have to double check them. I had a check before I came down here. I didn't anticipate anyone to know about the bus.
Can I ask about the
Civic
bus
I have no further legal advice I can give you. Obviously, you know that when you make a decision, you have to consider the evidence that's been put in front of you and what you've heard from the applicants. But at the same time, obviously, you're promoting the licensing objectives, making a decision that's both appropriate and proportionate. That's it.
Can I ask for any closing statement from the applicant?
Yes, well, I can say, I mean, we've done everything that we could do to our potential till now. And there has never been a problem in that area. So, because we've lived there for such a long time. And we know most of our customers there are close friends to us now. And we did help the local authority and the police, and we'll continue to do that if we have to. So, but there is a problem for us to do that in the first place. Yeah. That's it from us. Thank you.
The subcommittee are now going to retire in closed session. And if I can ask the legal advisory clerk to join me. And I don't think there are any members of the public here, so I think we're...
Steve.
Yeah. If any members of the public filming that they please ensure their cameras are now switched off until the subcommittee return to public session. I'd like to reopen the public session, and I'm going to invite the legal officer to present the advice provided during the private session.
So, what we normally do is explain to you what legal advice has been given, just so you're aware. During the deliberations, the committee were looking at the representation, the evidence provided with that, as well as going over what you'd presented to them. I gave them legal advice referring to a particular case, what's known as the Waits case, which requires a representation to provide sufficient evidence for a proper evidence to for the decision to be made, and for certain conditions or certain ways of looking at a decision, and they were looking at that in connection with the actual Councillor Kirby's representation, and that's all the advice I gave.
Sorry, so we have come to a decision, and we are going to grant it in its entirety. And the reasons for granting is the lack of evidence in Councillor Kirby's representation. And in addition, there was no objection of any responsible authority, especially the police, to this application. And I think on behalf of the subcommittee, I'd like to wish you good luck.
Thank you very much.
And all parties should receive a written copy of the decision notice within 5 working days, and I declare the hearing closed. Thank you.